quite interesting. I read, I think it was an American article, I need to be with you, and the journalist interviewing you found a quote about actor Song very early on in your collaboration together, where you described him as having a fascinating voice color. I'm curious, I've never heard that phrase before. It's a beautiful description of someone.
He actually does have a fascinating voice for it, even as he's talking right now and in his phone as well.
그리고 직접 그 세트장 현장에서 일하는 감독이나 또 그 온셋 사람들과 다르게 동시에 기사님 입장에서 더 민감하게 딱 공감하다는 부분. 그러니까 소리 아주 작게 속삭여도 그 대사가 아주 정확하게 귀속까지 완전히 한번도 다. 대사의 전달을 여기다가 정말 놀라운 것이죠.
So as a director and even the sound recorders on set all feel that way. Everyone's very sensitive to his voice because even when he whispers, you understand immediately the nuance of his lines and it's just embedded in your ears. He has amazing expressive strength in his voice.
짧은 하나의 단어도 아마 수만 가지로 표현하실 수 있을 거예요. 수만 가지의 뉘앙스로.
You can express a million things with just one short word.
처음에 얘기를 들었을 때 제가 박사장님 한 줄 알았어요.
When I first heard about this story from Director Bong, I thought I was going to play Mr. Park. I never imagined that I would be dragged into the bunker and go through all those struggles.
잘
you were talking about voice, I thought since my voice is very elegant and deep, I would play that kind of character as well. But obviously, that did not happen.
I did have an inkling that going into this film, I knew that you were both friends and started your collaboration on film. But I wondered at the end of the film, were you still friends?
Actually, we don't really have a lot of conversations.
그리고 또 세트장 촬영 현장에서도 또 그렇게 별 얘기 안 해요.
And also on set, we hardly talk.
집안의 내부인 차니까 어떤 심리적인 어떤 표현 이런 것.
it was actually just being in the sewage water and witnessing your home fill up with water and making sure that that comes across emotionally. That was the challenge of shooting that sequence.
사실상 이제 우연하자면 그게 허가란 어떤 그게 그 이제 그 안지아집과 전체 동네를 다 우리가 센터로 만들고 뭐 그렇게 해야 우리가 정교하게 물의 높이나 이 모든 걸 컨트롤할 수 있기 때문에 그 상태에서 이제 미리 준비를 되게 세밀하게 해서 스페셜 이펙트 팀하고도 준비를 되게 섬세하게 해서 이제 촬영이 들어간 거긴 한데
So to add that entire neighborhood and the semi-basement home were built in a giant water tank and we prepared meticulously for that sequence because we had to be able to control the height of the water as well and so we worked with the special effects team to pay attention to every detail for that sequence.
그래도 그럼에도 불구하고 이제 마지막 이제 뒷부분에 이제 그 씬의 뒷부분에 이제 이 디펙 이제 강호선 배가 지금 물건 몇 개를 챙겨서 이렇게 빠져나오는 거잖아요. 물이 거의 여기까지 왔거든요. 물과 이 천장 사이의 공간이 되게 작아요. 이제 물이 정말 높고 그 물높이는 물론 우리가 컨트롤하고 있지만 실제로 거기 저도 들어가 있었는데 실제 그 상황 자체가 되게 좀 공포스러워요. 그래서 근데 오히려 그 장면에서 되게 그 강호 선배의 표정이나 이런 걸 보면 되게 어떤 그 저도 그 표정 얼굴 때문에 되게 울컥했었는데 그 장면 현장에서 그게 약간 무시무시한 상황이지만 거기서 엄청나게 또 섬세한 표현을 하신 것 같은 그런 느낌.
Particularly at the end of that sequence, you have Kitek trying to leave the house with a couple belongings in his arms, and the water is right up to his chin, and there's hardly any space between the water and the ceiling. And I was there in the water shooting. Although we were controlling the height of the water, it was quite fearful to actually be there and watch the water come up. But nonetheless, he managed to portray all the emotions on his face. And you know, they were such delicate expressions that he had shooting in that horrific sequence. And watching that on set, I actually teared up as well.
To look at all of your films going back to your first film, Barking Dogs Never Lie, just set in the park block, and you have these never-ending corridors, and as is the case with a Bong Joon Ho film, a really great basement. There is this engagement with claustrophobia in your films, long corridors, basements, places that feel uncomfortable to us. If you could talk a little bit about both the locations in this film, because they are fascinating the way that you film them.
Mm. 뭐 말씀하신 대로 사공열차처럼 이제 그 두 시간 내내 기차에 갇혀 있다가 마지막에서 탈출하는 뭐 또 뭐 판다세이나 또 저희 단편 영화에서는 항상 지하실이 또 괴물에서도 그렇고 지하 괴물에서는 하수고 왜 이렇게 제가 지하 공간을 좋아하는지 잘 모르겠는데 특히 이번 기생충에서는 이제